Hello guys, welcome to Physics Insight. In the last video of this series, we have discussed how to find wave function and energy value for different level in infinite 1D potential well. If you haven't seen that video, I will recommend you guys to see that video first. I have mentioned the link of the video in the description. Now in this video, we will discuss how a particle behaves in a finite potential well. Before starting, don't forget to subscribe our channel for more such content. Consider a box having a finite potential at its wall. Let's say this is V equal to 0, this is V equal to V naught. Means this is having a potential difference of V naught. And now consider a particle in the box with mass m. Now we can say that this particle is in bound state when its energy is less than V naught. And when its energy is greater than V naught, then this particle is in unbound state or scattering state. Means particle can be anywhere. So in this video, we are going to discuss when particle is in bound state, means the case when E is less than V naught. If the energy of this particle is less than V naught, then classically this particle cannot penetrate the box. But quantum mechanically, due to the existence of wave nature of the moving particle, there is a finite probability that particle will penetrate the box up to a significant distance. So let's start with the Schrodinger equation, that is minus h squared square upon 2m del square phi by del x square plus p of x phi equal to e phi. Now let's name this region as 1, 2 and 3 and point this it as x equal to 0, it is, and this one as x equal to minus a by 2, and this is as x equal to a by 2. This equation can also be written as del square phi by del x square plus 2m by h cut square e minus p of x phi equal to 0. So let's start with region 1, that is from minus infinity to minus a by 2. In this region 1, we have Vx equal to V naught, so our Schrodinger equation become let's name this quantity as k1. So del square phi by del x square equal to minus k1 phi. Solution to this differential equation is given as phi equal to a exponential k1 x plus b exponential minus k1 x. Let's name this wave function as phi1, which represents wave function in region 1. In region 2, that is between minus a by 2 and a by 2, here v of x equal to 0. So our this Schrodinger equation becomes let's name this constant as k2. So our equation becomes solution to this differential equation is given as phi 2 represents wave function in region 2. Now region 3, that is between a by 2 and infinity, here potential is V naught and our solution, and in this our wave function solution is of same form as in the region 1. So phi 3 is equal to f e k1 x plus g e minus k1x, where k1 is same as in the region 1. Now for the existence of the bound state, for existence of bound state, wave function at plus minus infinity should be 0. So phi at minus infinity is equal to, let's first name the equations. Consider this equation as one, this equation as two, this equation as three. So putting x equal to minus infinity in equation one, we get, so from this equation we can say that, so this term goes to zero, and as wave function at minus infinity is equal to zero, so we can say that for this term to be 0, b should be 0. Similarly, for phi at infinity t, we get f equal to 0. So from these two condition, b equal to 0 and f equal to 0, we can say that phi 1 equal to a e k1x and phi 3 equal to g e minus k1x. As potential, v of x is symmetric in nature, so phi must be definite in parity. So we have two types of state, even bound state and odd bound state. Means we have even parity wave function and odd parity wave function. So for even parity wave function, phi 1 of x equal to a e k1x, phi 2 of x equal to d cos k2x, phi 3 of x equal to g e minus k1x. For odd parity, phi 1 of x is same as in the even parity, phi 2 equal to c sine k2x, and phi 3 is also same. Now using this equation, we can plot the wave function. As we are seeing that the below and the upper one are symmetric about x equal to 0, that means they corresponds to even parity, and the middle one is antisymmetric about x equal to 0, so it is of odd parity. In this plot, we are seeing exponentially decaying wave function on both sides of the box. This means that there is a finite probability of the particle to penetrate the walls of the box. Now we need to work on the boundary conditions to find out the energy values. At x equal to a by 2 and minus a by 2, we have a finite discontinuity. So that means that del phi by del x at x equal to a by 2 and minus a by 2 is continuous, and phi is also have to be continuous for bound state. Be continuous to be a wave function. So applying these two boundary conditions at x equal to a by 2 and minus a by 2, we will solve this problem. So let's start with this. Let's first use phi is continuous. Let's first deal for the even parity case. Phi 2 at x equal to a by 2 is equal to phi 3 at x equal to a by 2. So this equation gives us d cos k2 a by 2 equal to g e minus k1 a by 2. And condition of derivative continuity gives us del phi 2 by del x at x equal to this equation gives k2 name it as equation 5. Now dividing equation 5 by 4, we get k2 tan k2 a by 2 equal to k1. Now multiplying a by 2 on the both sides, we get k2 a by 2 tan k2 a by 2 equal to k1 a by 2. Now use k2 a by 2 as p and k1 a by 2 as q, then this equation will become p tan p equal to q. So now here comes the trouble. Here p and q both are function of energy, so this equation cannot be solved mathematically. We have to solve this equation graphically. So let's first change this variable q in terms of p. So for that we have to square p and q and add them. So what we get is and k1 and k2 are 2me minus v naught upon h cut square, and k2 is 2me by h cut square. So k1 whole square plus k2 whole square equal to, so k1 square and k2 square is equal to 2me by h cut square whole square and v naught square. So put this in above equation, we get and say this term as r square, which is constant whose value only depends on v naught and a. Now we can write q as under root of r square minus p square. So our main equation becomes p tan p is equal to r square minus p square. So we have to solve this equation graphically to find the energy values. Similarly, for the odd parity bound states performing same steps of step, we get minus p cot p is equal to q, which can be written as p tan pi by 2 plus p is equal to r square minus p square. So now here question is how to solve these kinds of equations. So let's take the case of even parity, where equation is p tan p is equal to r square minus p square. Let's make some change in this equation. P equal to r square by p square minus 1 under root. So what we will do here is we will draw the left hand side means 10p graph. A graph of 10p looks like this. So we have to plot right hand side on this graph. So plotting right hand side on this graph. So plotting right hand side on this graph, something look like this. And the intersection of these points gives us the solution of the above equation. Means it gives the value of p, and using this p value we can determine the energy value. Now depending on the value of v naught and a, our r increases. With increase in r, our number of bound state increases. As we are seeing in the graph, when the value of right hand side is less than pi, then we have only one bound state, but when it crosses pi, we are having two bound states. Similarly, when it crosses 2 pi, we are having 3 bound states. This is the solution to even parity state. Similarly, for odd parity state, we have to plot 10 pi by 2 plus p, which something looks like. So from here, we can calculate the value of p for the odd parity states. So that's all for this video. So in this video we have discussed about the behavior of particle in 1D finite potential well and discussed how the energy values are calculated for different levels for a finite potential. Hope you like the video. Please don't forget to subscribe our channel. Thank you.